Morning, everyone. My name is Marguerite, and we just waited for the sunrise. From a far distance, we could hear the ground hornbills calling. So we decided to follow the sound a little bit. Sounds like we're a little bit closer now. They're just in the thicket here in front of us. If you listen carefully, you can hear them. So in English, they're called the ground hornbills. And then in Afrikaans, they're called bromvoël. And the reason why they're called bromvoël is because of this very deep sound that they make. So we'll just wait around a little bit, see if we can find them. You'll see a lot of animals, not only birds, but especially early mornings with the birds, you'll hear all of the birds calling. And what it does is just with the sun rising, obviously the temperature is a lot cooler, and the sound will travel further. So they just, by the sounds of it, they're on the ground. So they're just walking around, marking their territory. Doing it now compared to doing it 1 or 2 o'clock in the middle of the day, it's really hot. The sound's not going to travel that far. Not many other birds are going to hear it. By doing it now, they can inform other hornbills properly that this is their territory. And what's amazing is this sound you can hear for up to about 4 or 5 kilometers. And a group of birds, their territory will be anything between 7 to 8,000 hectares. So they have extremely large territories, and that's why the sound needs to be able to travel this far. The wildebeest. So it sounds like they're going in a little bit deeper. If you look in the book, the ones at the bottom, there you can see what they look like. They have this very reddish crop at the bottom. The juveniles don't have color yet. It's completely black at first, and then only later on they'll start going a little bit yellow, orange, and then after a few years they'll be completely red in the face. How to tell the difference between your males and females can be quite difficult. You need to see them extremely close or use binoculars. But if you look at the red crop, you'll see that the females has the little blue patch underneath over there, and then the males are just completely red in color. I hope that we'll get to see them properly sometime soon. I think we're definitely on the right track. We came across a little bit of an obstacle. It is a nice big elephant foot. So we're just gonna quickly try and remove it, and then we'll continue on for the search. We kept searching for another hour, but this time around we were unfortunately unsuccessful. Although we could hear the ground hornbills, it was impossible to locate them. But it's just another indication of how far they sound actually travel early in the morning. We left hoping we'll have better luck next time. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up, and if you haven't already, don't forget to hit the subscribe button below.